Hello, everybody. Welcome to Bass and Bonsai. This is how you do it. Big, giant, largemouth bass. And oh yes, she's a kisser. Mwah. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show. Today, real quick, well, I'm going fishing, but for this little short video, this is just a heads up on the comparison. I'm going to be doing little shootout videos. So if anybody's got questions on which rod of the Kuying line, they want one, but they're not sure, should they spend the extra, you know, 30 bucks and get the Kuying Conqueror 6.5 BFS. They're both one piece, that's 6.61. This is one you remember I've used all last year. Had real good luck with it. I'm gonna show you the main differences real quick in this video. I've talked about them like in some live videos, but this video I'll go a little more in depth on what the differences are. This is the Kuying Teton 6.61. It's considered a light. Now the ratings say 2 to 10 grams, 3 to 8 pound line. It'll handle like way more than that. You've seen me throw, I've thrown the whopper plopper with it. It's a stouter rod than the ratings. It will go down as low as the ratings say, but you know, 2 grams, 16th ounce, it'll throw it. Both of them throw a crappie jig about 50 feet. You see me do that. The main thing I really use BFS stuff is starting out a 16th ounce type shaky head with a soft plastic. It's gonna weigh more than 16th ounce, roughly 1/8 ounce. So the main two differences on these rods, the sensitivity is very close. I haven't caught a fish on the new one yet, so I'll go into more of that. If I catch one today, I'll add it onto this video. But with the Kuying Teton, it is actually a lighter, they both have a light rating, but it's lighter overall. And I'm gonna try to show you if you can make out, see where that tip starts to bend, and then it bends. If you can make it out how much further down into the, you know, rod and the backbone it comes down. It's almost, it's got a little soft up here, then it gets a little stiffer, but the whole rod flexes. I mean, it flexes, I almost hooked myself, down into here really. I mean, it's got a lot of flex. So it's what I call like a mid flex, almost a full flex rod. Now the 6.5, it has this, coating all the way up to here, which actually makes this, it still flexes there, but it makes it a lot stiffer than the Kuying Teton. And if you can see, it's got a lot faster, the tip section comes in, and then somewhere above halfway it flexes a little, but it's a lot stiffer. And I'm going to try to show you, this is almost impossible to do side by side, I can get it figured out here, what I'm talking about when these things flex. See that different flex arc? It's not a huge difference, but the Kuying Teton definitely is a, and it's got a slightly softer tip. You can't really tell how much pressure I'm putting on them, but it takes me more pressure to get it, the tip to do that, than it does with Kuying Teton. Also, you can just tell it's a softer feel, that is a lot softer to that point, and it's flexing further down in. But as far as throwing, they'll both easily cast out, you know, light bait, 16th ounce crappie jigs. I did a shootout video, the sound, I had the neighbor painting, so I really, I mean, I guess you guys really insist that I put on a 16th ounce crappie jig. I got different reels on them, but I'm telling you, it's about 55 foot, they're very similar. I thought this was gonna actually beat it by at least 5 foot, like every cast, easy every time, but that's not the case. And then, before I get out of here, this rod right here, I'll show you the flex on it in case you're debating the 6.8. 6.8 medium light is, you can tell, a lot stiffer, and it has about the same flex, just takes more to get it to flex than the 6.5, but it's definitely a stouter rod. But it's got, you know, that 16th ounce shaky head jig with a little soft plastic, and it will zing a bait out there, you know, no problem. Pretty much as well as the other two. It's just going to have, you know, if you got a little bit thicker hook, or you want to go to the eighth, quarter, something like that, that's why I would recommend probably this one or the 6.5. And if you just are going to go like 16th ounce, say hard baits, you know, with treble hooks, and smaller 16th ounce or smaller, the Kuying Teton 661 or even the 632. And unfortunately, they don't make the 632 in a one piece. They don't make a 631. They make 632, which the last thing signifies how many pieces it is. I guess you guys do know that about Kuying, right? Or most rods. Some rods are different, but 6'5" means it's 6 foot five. 6'8" means it's 6 foot eight, and then the, you know, medium light. Now, if it has on the Kuying Teton, that second number, if it's 661, one piece, 632, two piece. Got it. Okay. All right. And then if you're just watching me on the overall Conqueror lineup and you want to know about them, I'll throw this on at the end of this video real quick. I'm just now trying this rod out too. You kind of see that's what I'm kind of why I went with all the Conqueror lineup. It, see that flex? Almost the three I have, I'm still waiting on 6'6" and a 6 foot 10. But they have almost that same flex to them. It takes more pressure to get it to flex like that, but they almost have the same feel. And that's what I'm kind of wanting to go for. But this is going to be my pretty much anything half ounce or three quarter. And maybe a 6 foot 10 might take over frog duties, but I should be able to throw pretty much anything with this, just like I did with the old Fantasista rod. But it's pretty stout. It's a 6'7" medium heavy. It recommends quarter to 1 ounce, 12 to 20 pound line. And that's about right what I got. I got, like, say, 20 pound braid with 15 pound P-Line original leader. If you guys can see, I'm trying to get out here and fish, but I just want to give you guys a quick heads up on this video, because that's the most asked question I've got, are these, as the Conquerors go, that I just picked up in the Kuying Tetons. If I had to recommend, I like the fact I got both of them. They fit. They're not the exact same rod, so this is a touch softer and this is a little stouter. They'll fit right in. You can see I got a 16th ounce shaky head with the 7-inch worms. I got a 16th ounce shaky head with the actual zinkers. So you can throw, and I could throw either or with it. It's not that big a deal. I could switch them up. Let's do a double. Let's see if we can catch some fish out here today. Look at that, fishing with two rods. What are the odds, huh? Maybe I do need a left-handed reel so I can sit here and do this and one over here and do some trick shooting. What do you think? All right, that's enough for me. I'm out of here. What I'm actually doing is this ice, I'm just waiting for it to melt. The day it's getting warmer, it's going to be almost 60 degrees or 61. I'm not sure. I've heard two things, 59 and 61. Either way, this ice should be melted before I leave. And I'm coming right back here tomorrow. I kind of helped it out. If you know, watch this, look forward to this fishing video if I catch a fish. But I'll probably still show it on there of how it took me to get this ice started, headed the way of getting melted. But here they are. The difference, I guess if you guys can make that out, there's not much of a difference. This actually came with almost this same look in the, you know, this type of cork. Reel seats are exactly the same. The Kuying Teton's just slightly, about an exact inch. That's why it's 6'6". This is 6'5". And just that much more softer. So I highly, and this one doesn't have that, like, little extra soft coating. This one does, but my 6'8" didn't have that. I'm not sure why. It's just and it actually didn't even have this, like, a gray. It's more of just a painted black like that. All right, guys, I'm out of here. Hope you like this video. Look forward to different shootouts. Once I get on a decent bite, I'll alternate between them and see about sensitivity. As of right now, I think it's going to be exactly the same. These are sensitive rods. When you're using braid, I mean, I can feel the little ticks. I could in the grass. I can feel it out here. On that bigger one, I'm going to throw in a chatterbait. I mean, you can feel it chattering just like I did with my high-end Fantasista rod. So I think they're pretty sensitive, but until I actually start catching fish on them, I won't know. All right, get out of here. Go bass and bonsai somewhere else. I got fish to catch. Thanks for watching, guys.
Let's catch another one.
There we go. I think that's a fish coming at me. Oh yeah. We're on to something, boys and girls. Square bill, 39 degree water temps, and they don't want the soft plastics. They want this little, they want their little brother. Oh, whoa, whoa. All right. Whoa, that is a flopping man. They're active. I'll tell you what, that is an active little bass. Look at that bass. He's got a big old tail and not that big. Mwah. Mwah. I'm going to get a quick pick just to prove to people that I'm actually started catching fish. I think some people doubted I would be able to. Exactly how we do it. Big largemouth bass. Let's see if it'll jump. That is a beauty.
It's gonna jump.